بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear students, already it has been explained that Pakistan is divided into four climatic zones. Pakistan is divided in four climatic zones: highland zone, lowland zone, coastal zone, and arid zone. Arid. So which areas are in which climatic zone? Okay, so already a few points, okay, have been explained. So I will explain coastal climatic zone again, beta. First of all, which areas have this type of climate? The southern part of Pakistan, the south part of Pakistan, so that has coastal climate, beta, because that is connected, okay, with the Arabian Sea. If we start from the southeast part of Pakistan, extreme southeast part, so there is a place, Run of Kutch, beta. And if we start our journey from Run of Kutch, and if we go to the southwest part of Pakistan, extreme southwest part of Pakistan, so there is a point, area name is Jiwani, beta. Jiwani is the last point. Jiwani is the last point, beta. Till there, we have coastal areas. And the coastline of Pakistan is divided into two coasts: Sindh coast and Makran or Balochistan coast, beta. Sindh coast or Makran and Balochistan coast. Sindh coast, you know, which is in Sindh province, and Makran or Balochistan coast is in Balochistan, beta. So this is the location, okay, where we have coastal type of climate, beta. They say rainfall is scanty, okay, throughout the year, variable amount, beta, from place to place, okay, variable amount, time to time, okay, variable amount, beta. You know, there is a maritime effect, beta. I can explain maritime effect again, beta. Maritime effect or influence is that it means the effect of water on the land. Effect of water on the land. This point has already been explained that those areas which are near the coastline, the areas which are near the coastline, so they are affected, okay, from the local winds by dear, local winds, coastal winds, land breeze and sea breeze, beta. So this remains, okay, throughout the year, beta. That's why temperature does not go down and temperature does not go up, beta. Temperature remains moderate, beta, okay, and we say this is maritime effect, maritime influence, okay. It means the effect of land breeze and sea breeze. Land breeze is from land to sea, and sea breeze is from sea to land, beta. Daytime, nighttime, okay, this continues, and temperature remains moderate. And near the coastline, okay, we have more humidity level, beta, because water evaporates, okay, from the sea, and water vapors, the amount that remains more, okay, near the coastline. And also the land and water, their absorbing capacity and releasing of heat capacity, okay, that is different, beta. You know, land heats up quickly and cools down quickly. land heats up quickly and cools down quickly. And water has more capacity to absorb the heat. Water has more capacity to absorb the heat. But when water releases the heat, it releases slowly. It does not release the heat at once, okay, as land does that better. You know, in the morning when sun rises, so first of all, the land part is heated up better. Then the air which is over the land, so that is heated up. That's why that, okay, we feel heat. We feel, okay, temperature as we are very close to the land part better. But if we go up, my dear, so then temperature would decrease with altitude increase with. With the increase of altitude, temperature decrease. So this is about the maritime effect with. Maritime effect is the effect of water on the land with. Effect of water on the land, it means the local winds, sea breeze and land breeze, okay, so they affect the areas which are near the coastline better. But as we go away from the coastline, mean from sea, so then the effect of, I mean, maritime effect, okay, it decreases. And gradually it goes to 0% barrier. And then we have other factors. And due to other factors, okay, we have different type of climate better. So this is about the coastal climatic zone. The south part of Pakistan with. Now we have arid climate with arid climate. First of all, the areas which have this type of climate with arid climate. So southeastern desert. So what is the name of southeastern desert with any student? What is the name of southeastern desert?
Thar Cholistan
desert, beta. Very good. And southwestern desert? Which is in Balochistan, Karan. Near Chagri Hills?
Kharan,
beta. Okay, beta. Now we come to know that arid climatic zone, the areas are southeastern desert and southwestern desert. Southeastern desert is Thar Choristan desert, and southwestern desert is Kharan desert, beta. Kharan. Okay. Rainfall here is also low. Annual rainfall is low in these two deserts, beta. And rainfall comes, okay, in different time period of the year, beta. Like if we talk about Thar Choristan desert, in Thar Choristan desert mostly we have monsoon, summer monsoon rainfall, beta. Summer monsoon rainfall happens, okay, in this area, beta. Southeastern desert, Thar Choristan desert, and southwestern desert, as we call it as Kharan desert, here rainfall happens in winter. There is rainfall only in winter season, beta. Winter season. Okay, so we will study, okay, the next topic, that of sources of rainfall. Sources of rainfall in Pakistan. That from which sources do we get rainy water, okay? Or rainfall happens in Pakistan. So in Pakistan, there are five sources which can bring rainfall in Pakistan. Five sources with it. And one source is active in winter. One source is active in winter. And that system brings rainfall in southwestern desert. It means the Kharan Desert. And that rainy system is called as Western Depressions. Western Depressions beta. Monsoon winds, so they are active in Pakistan in summer. In summer, okay, after June or in the mid of June, okay, so they start affecting, okay, Pakistan beta. But in July and August, we have so much effect of monsoon winds in Pakistan. In July and August, okay, we have so much rainfall in Pakistan, and that is due to monsoon winds. Then we have other system too, beta. Convectional type of rainfall also happens. Relief rainfall also happens in Pakistan. Western Depression is in winter in Pakistan. From month of December to March. Month of December to March, Western Depression is active in Pakistan. So inshallah, when we will study about the sources of rainfall, so I will explain their formation and their roots. Plus the fifth one is the tropical cyclones. Tropical cyclones, beta, which are formed in or over Arabian Sea, and then they move towards India, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, and even towards Oman, okay, they move that, even some African countries, okay, so they're also affected. From the tropical cyclones, okay, which are formed in Arabian Sea, Indian Ocean. Any point, beta? Any
no,
point you did not understand, beta? You can ask me, beta.
No, sir.
So tell me, Muhammad Abdul Rahman, which areas are of arid climate zone, beta?
Sir, southwestern.
Southwestern what?
Balochistan.
Southwestern, beta, what? Desert, beta.
It's a southwestern desert and
yeah.
Kharan and
any other student, beta? Which areas have type of climate? Why is I just explained, beta?
Sir, southeastern and southwestern deserts, which is the right. Third Choristan desert and the Kharan desert.
Yes, beta. Southeastern desert, so that is a third Choristan desert. And southwestern desert is Kharan desert. Okay, so they have arid type of climate. Very hot and dry, beta. Very much hot and dry, okay, and in winter very much cold and dry, beta. Very much cold and dry. Okay, boy, so we are going to the next, beta. The factors accounting for climatic variations. The factors which are accountable for climatic variations within Pakistan. But within Pakistan, okay, we have four climatic zones, beta. Four climatic zones. So which factors are involved in that? That a small country is having, okay, four different climatic variations, beta. Within the country, okay, we have four different climatic zones. So there are some factors, okay, which we can see that, okay, and I will explain, okay, one by one, beta. First factor is latitude, beta, latitude. We define latitude distance from equator. Distance from equator. It means how much close and how much far away equator, far away from equator we are located, beta. In introduction of Pakistan, you read that Pakistan is located on line of latitude from which degree to which degree? Who remembers that, beta? On line of latitude, Pakistan is located on which line of latitude, beta? Come on, boys.
Sir, 24 and 35.
37 beta.
37.
Very good beta. Pakistan is located, okay, on line of latitude from 24 degree north to 37 degree north beta. Okay. So we say that Pakistan is stretched so much on line of latitude. Pakistan is stretched, okay, so much on line of latitude. Mean Pakistan is so much spread, okay, on line of latitude, beta. So that is the reason, beta. For the heat which is reaching on 24 degree latitude, same will not reach on 37 degree of latitude, beta. Cause as sun's heat has to travel a long distance, my dear. So the same heat does not reach to that point, beta. Again, the same heat which reaches on equator, that heat does not reach near the North Pole, beta. Because the sun's heat has to cover a long distance, and when it reaches the North Pole, beta, so same heat does not reach over there. That's why places, areas near the North Pole, so they are colder. They are colder bit. So Pakistan is so much spread, okay, on line of latitude bit. And that is the reason we have variation, okay. Same heat which reaches on 24 degree Celsius, 24 degree latitude, same heat is not reaching, okay, at the place of 37. So one thing beta, latitude. So latitude, temperature is related to latitude beta. And latitude means, okay, distance from equator. Distance from equator. How much close to equator, how much far away from equator are you, my dear? The second factor, sir, is of altitude.
Sir?
Yes, Peter.
Riyadh is on the equator, right?
No, not on equator, Peter.
Is it on the South Pole or the North Pole?
It is on the Northern Hemisphere, Peter.
Northern Hemisphere. Thank you, sir.
It is not very close to equator, beta. So, beta, altitude.
So altitude means height. Closer to the equator, it's going to be hotter, right?
If something, yes, if any place is close to the equator, so that will be hotter one, beta.
Thank you, sir.
Altitude means height. How much above the sea level are you, beta? So you know that the altitude of Pakistan, so that varies, okay, from place to place. If we start our journey, okay, from Karachi, from south part of Pakistan, so here we are not so much above the sea level. वी आर अ फ्यू मीटर्स ओके अबव द सी लेवल बेटा, एंड एज वी स्टार्ट आवर जर्नी एंड वी गो टू द एक्सट्रीम नॉर्थ पार्ट ऑफ पाकिस्तान, सो यू गो टू द हाइट ऑफ मोर देन 8,000 meters. And you read in grade 6 about normal lapse rate. Normal lapse rate, beta. Does any student remember that? What is normal lapse rate? Yes, beta. Uzefa, Hassan Bajwa, Ahmed. Ahmed is not there. Ahmed is there. What is normal lapse rate, beta? Zain, Noor, Rehan, Kundi, Hassan, Daniel, Ahmed Siddiqui, Abdurrahman, Mubashir, Faik, Huzaifa, Ahmed Alam, Abdurrafe, Abdullah Subhan. But the normal lapse rate is after every 1,000 meter in height. After every 1,000 meter in height, there is a decrease in temperature. There is decrease in temperature, beta, and the decrease rate is 6.5 degrees Celsius. After every 1,000 meter in height, temperature decreases and the decrease rate is 6.5 degrees Celsius. And if you are at the height of 8,000 meters, so you can understand that how much would be the temperature there, beta. There will be less temperature and you will be having a different type of climate there, beta. And if you are near the sea, you will be having different type of climate. If you go to the height of 4,000 meter, different type of climate. 6,000 meter, different type of climate. So altitude means the height of the land. Height of the land, okay, above the sea level. So that also affects the temperature and even your climate, beta. The third one is distance from sea, beta. Distance from sea. How much far away are you from the sea, beta? Or how much close are you from the sea, beta? So if you are near the sea, as already this point has been explained, beta, you will be having moderate type of climate. And this type of climate will remain throughout the year. Cause land breeze and sea breeze, so they normalize the temperature. They do not let okay temperature to rise, and they don't let okay temperature go down the freezing point. So the south part of Pakistan, so that has coastal type of climate, moderate type of climate. That's why that temperature does not go down the freezing point, and the water which we have in Arabian Sea, so that is not changed into solid shape, beta. That's why that, okay, we say warm water port. Warm water ports, okay, so they have the benefits. The ships, okay, they can come, okay, any time of the year. They can be loaded, unloaded, okay. More activities, okay, at the seaport. More goods, okay, can be exported, and more goods, okay, can be imported, okay, from other countries. So distance from sea, beta, so that also affects, okay, your climate. Suppose you start your journey, okay, from Dammam, beta. So the land area near Dammam, near the sea, so that will be having moderate type of climate. And as the distance, okay, increases, so effect of water on the land would decrease, beta. And the time would come that there will be no effect, okay, on the land part. There will be no effect, okay, on the land part, okay? And there will be now other factors. Like in Riyadh city, Riyadh is not affected, okay, from the sea which is near Dammam Beta or the sea which is near Jeddah. Because Riyadh is very much far away, okay, from Dammam and Jeddah. In the same way, Lahore is also far away, okay, from Karachi. So Karachi is affected, okay, from the local winds. But as we go away, okay, from Karachi, from coastline of Pakistan, so then the effect of water on the land, okay, so that start to decrease beta. And the point comes that it goes to 0% beta. Then we, like in Riyadh city, or Riyadh city is not affected beta from the sea which is near Dammam or Jeddah. We have some other factors here beta. We have some other factor, okay? One factor is of latitude. That on line of latitude, okay, so we are not so much close to equator, but it is not so much close, okay, that we, I mean, Riyadh is on equator. No, far away from equator. But if we check the position, okay, from North Pole, so then Riyadh is close to the equator beta. So in Riyadh, sun's heat reach more beta than near the North Pole. That's why, okay, we have more temperature here beta. The altitude of Riyadh city is less, a few meters, 200 or 300 meter, okay, above the sea level. So 200, 300 meter, that will not affect the temperature. It should have been in 1000 beta, like Taif. Taif height is more than 2000 or maybe round about 3000 meter, okay, above the sea level. So Taif is cooler. Taif is cooler, okay? But Makkatul Mukarrama, that is very close to Taif Marir, 70 kilometer. That is the road distance Marir, okay? Land distance, we can say that. Maybe aerial route is less, okay, from Taif to Makkatul Mukarrama. Maybe 50 kilometer, maybe 60 kilometer, okay, depends on that. Just suppose that. But Taif is located on high altitude. More than 2000 meter, around about 3000 meter beta. So Taif has different type of climate, okay, and Makkah has different type of climate. And Makkah is close to the sea, you know that. Makkah is close to the sea, okay, because from Jeddah side, if we calculate the distance, okay, that is 60-65 kilometer. And the effect of water on the land, so that also reaches Makkatul Mukarrama. That's why Makkah has moderate type of climate. Moderate type of climate beta, okay? But as we go far away, okay, from Jeddah, so then the effect of water on the land, so that start decreasing beta. Then we have some other factors, okay, which are involved in that. Other factor is a continental effect beta. Continental. Does any student know that? What is the meant by continental?
The effect of the continent in which the country is present.
So related to continent.
Related to continent mean that? What is continent?
So it's a large piece of land.
Very good, beta. Very good, yes. So continental effect is effect of land on land. Effect of land on land, beta. Keep in mind that, beta. Remember that. Continental effect is effect of land on land, beta. So you have experienced, okay, in Riyadh city in summer. That at once, okay, wind blows and it carries, okay, dust and sand in that. And we have sandstorm in Riyadh city. Now, what is the reason? रीजन इज दैट बेटा, मे बी समवेयर मे बी इन रियाद सिटी, मिडल ऑफ रियाद सिटी बेटा, और अराउंड रियाद सिटी ड्यू टू राइज इन टेम्परेचर लो एयर प्रेशर वॉज क्रिएटेड बेटा. And keep in mind that, beta, the movement of the air is always from high air pressure to low air pressure. So wind at once, okay, blows and it carries, okay, sun, sand and dust, okay, in that. So we have sandy or dusty situation, okay, in Riyadh City, beta. So this is the effect of land on land beta. Anywhere beta, if low air pressure is created, so then keep in mind that the areas which have high air pressure, so wind will blow from high air pressure to low air pressure and it will try to normalize the temperature beta. It's a natural my dear, that nature wants to keep balance in the that area. In temperature, everything better. Nature wants to keep the balance. And when one area temperature rises, low air pressure is created. If any area is very close to that and it has high air pressure, so then wind will blow and it will normalize the temperature. How can we determine the speed of the wind beta? So I can explain that if the distance between high pressure area and low pressure area, if distance is less, so then the speed of the wind will be more beta. And if the distance is less beta, speed will be more. And if distance is more, my dear, between high pressure area and low pressure area, so then the speed of the wind will be slow beta. This is natural one beta. Okay. And we find the effect of the wind pressure beta, the speed of the wind. So we can feel that better. Inshallah, we will continue. If you have any question, you can ask me better.
No, sir.
No, sir.